going to be talking about shame. S-H-A-M-E. Shame. The series is Shame, Abandonment, and Rejection. So you need to ride this series out. And we're going to talk about shame this morning. We're going to go to the Word of God and find out a man that was in shame. He was left in shame, but God gave him a deliverance. You know, because you're in one spot in life or one segment in your life, that don't mean that you have to stay there. There's always deliverance that you can get help from. So we're going to the 16th chapter of the book of Judges. Judges, the 16th chapter and the 19th verse. Judges 16, 19. And she made him sleep upon her knees, and she called for a man, and she caused him to shave off 7 locks of his head. And she began to afflict him, and his strength went from him. And she said, "The Philistines be upon thee, Samson." And he awoke out of his sleep and said, "I will go out at other times before and shake myself." It must have been some kind of therapy that he did, or some kind of physical thing that Samson would do to cause the Spirit of God to come upon him. But anyway, he said, "I will go out at other times before and shake myself." And he wist not that the Lord was departed from him. But the Philistines took him and put his eyes out, knocked him out, babes, and brought him down to Gaza and bound him with fetters and brass. And he did grind in the prison house. Howbeit, the hair of his head began to grow again after he was shaven. Then the lords of the Philistines, just because you get knocked down, that don't mean it's over with. Then the Lord of the Philistines gathered them together for to offer up a great sacrifice unto Dagon their God, and to rejoice. For they said, "Our God has delivered Samson, our enemy, in our hand." They getting ready to have a party now. They going to boogie, woogie, oogie now. And when the people saw him, they praised their God, for they said, "Our God had delivered unto our hands our enemy and the destroyer of our country, which slew many of us." And it came to pass, when their hearts were merry, that they said, "Call for Samson that he may make us sport." They ready to make fun of him now. Old bald head man got his eyes put out. And they called for Samson out of the prison house, and he made them sport. And they set him between 2 pillars. That's where they made the mistake. And Samson said unto the lad that held him by the hand, "Suffer me that I may feel the pillars whereupon the house standeth, that I might lean." He didn't tell him what he was going to do. "That I may just lean on them, brother man. Just take me over there." Now the house was full of men and women, and all the lords of the Philistines were there. And there were upon the roof about 3,000 men and women that beheld while Samson was made fun of. You know, once the devil shame you, then he going to make fun of you. Oh my God. And Samson called unto the Lord and said, "O Lord." At least Samson had enough sense to repent.
Amen.
He said, "O Lord God, remember me, I pray thee, and strengthen me, I pray thee, only this once, O God, that I may be at once avenged of the Philistines for my 2 eyes." Once your eyes is out, you in bad shape. And Samson took hold of the 2 middle pillars which upon which the house stood and on which it was borne up, of the one which was right with his right hand and the other with his left. And Samson said, "Let me die with the Philistines." And he bowed himself with all his might, and the house fell upon the lords and upon all the people that were therein, so that the dead which he slew at his death were more than they which he slew in his life. God got the victory. Then his brother and all that house of his father came down and took him and brought him up and buried him between Zorah and Eshtaoa, in the burying place of Manoah his father. And he judged Israel for 20 years. Well, you know, I want to bring out a few points about Samson. Samson had a lot, he did a lot of good because he tried to deliver God's people out of bondage because the Philistines had got control of Israel. Let me introduce you to Samson. Who was Samson? Samson was a Nazarite. From his mother's womb, he was a Nazarite. And the vow was that he was not to drink strong drink and never to cut his hair. That's why his head was in locks, big old long lock. He had seven of them that were extra. It wasn't curly hair. It was dread. They called them dreadlocks that he grew his hair because he never had a haircut. He judged Israel for 20 years and he died at 40 years old. That's a young man to die. Well, let's talk a little bit about shame, y'all. Let's talk a little bit about shame since we're talking about that in our therapy. The experience of shame, a feeling of being unworthy, bad or wrong, can be extremely uncomfortable. Shame has the potential to change the way we see ourselves and may lead to long-lasting social, professional, and sexual difficulties. The word shame means different things to different people. Though shame is different from guilt and embarrassment. Anybody ever been guilt, had a guilt trip on them? Anybody ever been embarrassed? Guilt is usually understood to involve negative feelings about an act one has committed. I feel bad because I went out and done wrong. Went out and robbed somebody or committed whoredom or whatever. Now I feel bad about it. You know, and I'm not against, well, I believe, I guess, in the death penalty. But you know, some of these guys on death penalty, the atrocities that they have done to people, and then they don't want to die. You know, you got to look at what you did, man. Rape people, rob, kill, murder people, and now it's your time to die and you don't want to die. Oh my God, help us. Act one has committed, while embarrassed, deals with societal reaction. Shame, on the other hand, involves negative feelings about oneself. And although a person can be shamed by peers or society in general, shame can also be experienced secretly. A lot of people have secret shame that they're dealing with. A lot of young girls have been molested by their fathers and their brothers, and they got it on the inside, but they're ashamed to come forward with it. That's what's happening in our society. Unresolved shame can lead to feelings of what? Depression, anxiety, and low self-esteem. It says unresolved shame can lead to depression. Well, why are a lot of these people depressed? Something has went on in their life that they haven't been free to express because of fear. So now what are they doing? They're in a shell of depression and anxiety and low self-esteem. Shame may also be a symptom of some mental health diagnosis, such as body dysmorphia, or the product of a traumatic experience such as rape and sexual assault. Living with shame, regardless of the shame source, can be a lonely and demoralizing experience. Therapy can help. You hear what I said? What did I say? Therapy can help. Most people, and I probably was guilty myself, have had a lot of guilt in their lives. And they too proud to get help. They want to keep doing the same thing over and over. You want to keep hating certain people. You don't want to be set free from that. And that's bad. A lot of these undercover issues, like shame, causes sickness, causes depression. Well, you catch a person that's always depressed, even young or old, it's something went on in their life. And they haven't got over with it. Things happened to me when I was in the service, man, that caused depression. Oh my God, and anxiety. And when I left, I was still locked in, but I got delivered here and there. But when I went in that office and that man made me cry, I needed to cry it out. Some of y'all, you need to cry it out, the hurt. Some people have done things with their companion that they don't have enough God in them to confess that they went out and did it wrong, and they hoping it in. You know, you touch on something and they get all uneasy. Well, that's a sign that something went on and you hiding it. Oh, God, help us right now. Living with shame, going with shame so it can cause okay, therapy can help. Okay, the underlying cause when shame is due to a past misdeed, the right therapist can support a person to make amends or move on in life. It's something I learned about what happened to me in my family. I've gotten over that. The childhood whippings and, you know, I thought were unfair and all of that. I got over that because I had a chance to express before my father died how I really felt about a lot of things. And that's the problem. People don't get a chance. Before a lot of y'all can express something, how you really feel, your folks is dead and gone. And you didn't get a chance to really say what you really wanted to say. So what do? You just keep it in. Well, that's bad when you keep it in. Huh? All right, all right. Well, let's talk a little bit about Samson, y'all. Samson was once a man that walked in victory. Oh, Samson was an awesome man. God had chose him to deliver God's people. What did Samson do? Well, he started whooping on the Philistines. First thing he did, his parents told him, Samson was, can I say this? Samson was a big whore. Did y'all hear what I said? You need to read your Bible. People in the Bible got all kind of drama. And Samson didn't like women in his own camp, his own race or culture. He didn't like them Hebrew women. He liked them big, fine Philistine women. Somebody said, oh, Samson had two women. Now, historians say that Samson had about 30 women down there. Once a man get on a whoremongering spree, he got all kind of women.
Yeah, that's true.
And Samson is no different than people are today. All right, all right. So Samson once lived a life of victory because at this time, God was really, really not dealing with the people. And he allowed the people to go and do what they really want to do. Isn't that right, Mario?
Oh, yeah.
God tried to send a person that, he sent a judge there to help them get out of the mess they're in. Why would God's people always get in the trouble they're in? Because they stopped serving God. They always wanted to be like the people that are surrounding them. They all had a king, and God said, I don't want you to have a king, because all a king going to do is drain you. Put all your sons in war and take your girls and put them in the commissary and tax you to death. So God knew what he was doing. He wanted to have a theocracy where he could come and visit the people, you know, and have a relationship with the people. But you know what? They didn't want that. Same thing now. You know what? The American people, whether they're black or white, I don't think most folks, they don't know what they want. All they doing is living day by day. Most of them have no purpose, especially with God. And they just living day by day. A lot of people lying. They ain't got no COVID-19. They just want to stay at home. And they got laws. If you even sneeze on the job or your throat to go to tickling, then you can go home. Where they go home, what they do? Play games. Look at TV, the soap operas. Ain't nothing wrong with them. Hey, this is a bad time to have a lot of girlfriends, because who knows that some of them don't have COVID.
Oh, boy. That's tough.
And you around there, as they call it, throat kissing, and go fool around and get the COVID.
Uh-oh.
Oh, this is a good time to let them go. Come on here. This is a good time to get delivered. Oh, they are. I'm sick. I mean, I think there's some diseases out here. Hallelujah. All right, let's get back in this word. Let's talk more about Samson. Just like most people, Samson was living a free life. He could do what he wanted to do. And just like most people in the church, the church now is not a place of commitment and prayer.
No.
We're living in a dangerous hour, ladies and gentlemen. Anything can happen now.
Yeah.
The war in Iran, Russia's getting in it.
Oh, yeah.
And where's America at? I'm hearing very little about America getting involved, because we don't want to get involved. And in the book of Ezekiel 37-38, America's not even involved. Is she even existing? Anytime a nation of people forget about God, then God gonna allow them to be destroyed. 2022 is gonna be a year of judgment. So y'all prepare for it. I don't know what's gonna happen, but whatever happens, my prayer, I don't know about you, but my prayer is I'll be ready and I'll be strong to go through whatever happens.
Amen.
Can I get a witness?
Hallelujah. Amen.
Samson didn't, I'm going to get down to the 20th verse. Now, Samson had a lady down there in the Philistine women, a pretty woman by the name of Delilah. Delilah was a very attractive woman, but she was dangerous. Samson had the problem, you know, he was a player. And he had these riddles that people couldn't answer. And he always would throw out a riddle. Not only did he have riddles, but he would tell deep secrets that only him and God knew and his family. You got to be careful who you talk to. And you got to be careful who you let out information to. Why? Because they'll use it against you. If they ever stop liking you, they'll use it against you. And you got to be careful what you tell people. Don't tell me. If it's that sacred, don't tell me. Because I sure ain't going to tell you if it's something sacred. That somebody told me, oh no, my mouth is sealed. Oh my God. So Samson had a problem. He didn't have a problem, but he was just playing the people because he knew he was chosen by God. He knew he was anointed, and he knew he could whoop all these people. So he was just playing with them. So he went down there, and it's good to take advice from godly people.
Yes.
His parents told him, son, it's a girl, a lady's over here in your own race of people, your own culture. Why you want to go over there and get them worldly crazy women? And Samson told him, you go down there and get that woman like I told you to do. And God told them, oh, let it be. Why? Because he's fulfilling the will of God. So what happened to Samson? He went and got this worldly girl. And she told his riddle. She told the riddle that Samson had put out. And Samson was playing games with him because he would always play games with him with his strength. He said, well, if y'all just tie me up with a little rope and stuff, then I'll be just like any other man. And so what did they do? They tied Samson up. And they said, Samson, the Philistines be upon you. And he broke the cards. He broke the cards. Well, he kept right on playing until he told the main secret. Don't tell me what you won't do when you get under pressure. People are like, oh, I ain't going to do that. That old girl, she ain't going to get next to me. You just keep right on fooling with her. Samson kept right on fooling with Delilah because she was so fine. And she finally said, Samson, if you love me, tell me the secret, baby. Come on, tell mommy the secret. And Samson played with her and said, well, if you tie me up a certain way with a strong card, I'll just be like a natural man, baby. You know, any of y'all ever talk, like, is it romance talk or just talking noise?
Romance talk.
Yeah, come on, baby. Go ahead and tie me up. I'll be like a natural man. Well, he lied again. See, you got to stop lying to these old girls because they're going to catch on after a while. And so she said, Samson, if you really love me, you would tell me your secret, baby. Well, what did she do? She waited till she got that old boy down, and he was laying in her lap, weakened that old boy down. And Samson told his secret. You be careful who you share information with.
That's true.
And when she told his secret, see, Samson didn't know that God had already left him. Now, put it this way, it's reversed. He left God. God don't leave you, you leave him. He didn't even know it. He's playing so much out there, he's playing the girls, okay? Come on, Mario, we've been out there. Play the old girls, come on. Yeah, baby, I'll be going back. You know good well you ain't going up, you're going up to see another girl.
That's tough.
Yeah. Y'all know how people, man, that girl's kisses as sweet as strawberry wine. He right there talking about getting saved. Not now. I've been there. Come on here. Well, Samson kept on playing with her. And Samson, you know, he would always rise up and he would do a little therapy. He would shake himself. You know, he was so powerful and so fine, he'd shake himself. and the power of God would come up on Samson, and he whoop all of them.
Yeah.
Samson slew 1,000 Philistines with the jawbone of an ass.
Yeah.
1,000 men. Can you realize how powerful he was?
Mm-hmm.
And then the Philistines made him mad. So what did he do? He caught 300 foxes.
Uh-huh.
Tied their tails up and destroyed all their crops. Well, they mad now.
Yeah.
Hmm. Huh? Yeah. They couldn't catch him because they couldn't get close to him.
Huh.
But that old girl,
yeah.
That old prostitute.
Uh-oh.
The thing about Samson, he didn't like decent women, he liked whores.
Uh-huh. That's that.
Huh?
That's true. Uh-huh.
Same way with men now. A lot of us be, they don't know, no, no, I don't know virgin. I won't be a whore. I want to have some fun. Oh my God, that's how the devil got our minds tripped up.
Uh-huh.
Hmm? Hmm. He tied 300 foxes and destroyed the Philistines' crops.
Uh-huh.
They was mad. So she got Samson where she wanted him.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, Samson, now here's what happened was, she got, I don't know if she put him on a drug, he was smoking something or what? Come on here.
Uh-huh.
Drugs is old, y'all.
Yeah, they've been around.
Smoking that stuff is old. They've been doing that.
Uh-huh.
Or she could have put a little drug in his drink.
Uh-huh.
Who knows?
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, she had the old boy on his knees.
Mm-hmm.
Had him on his knees.
Uh-huh.
And she said, Samson, the Philistines is upon you.
Uh-huh.
And he rose up and said, you know what? I'm going to rise up and I'm going to shake myself. And when he rose up and shook himself, he was just like a natural man.
Uh-huh.
He didn't have a power because he had left God. God just don't leave you or you leave God. You leave God gradually.
Uh-huh.
And most people in the church, they left God. They don't know nothing about God. Because if they knew something about God, they wouldn't let the coronavirus dictate to them.
Uh-huh. That's true.
Hmm. And I ain't got nothing against masks. I wear masks too when I go in Walmart and around. Mm-hmm. I put on a mask, but I don't know what kind of people. Come on here.
Uh-huh.
Is up in there. People breathing crazy. Come on, y'all. Mm-hmm. One man I was talking to, and I put my head on my mouth. I said, well, what shelf is it on? You know, you got to be careful.
Mm-hmm.
What was that? We still talking about Samson.
Mm-hmm.
He shook himself.
Mm-hmm.
God was gone.
Mm-hmm.
If you're in church, you don't have the love of God in you no more. You need to shake yourself.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Samson had lost his relationship with God.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, Samson was chosen to deliver God's people.
Mm-hmm.
But he chose to do it his way. Huh? Mm-hmm. There's some old song called Frank Sinatra said, I did it my way.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why most folk is lost now. They did it their way and not God's way.
Mm-hmm.
So what did they do? They caught Samson. And the first thing they did was put his eyes out.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Come over here and destroy all our crops. We're going to show you something,
uh-huh.
Boy.
Let's go.
They chained him up and put his eyes out.
Yep.
Can you imagine having your eyes put out? Come here, Mario. Come here, Mario. Your eyes is out. I'm going to show y'all something.
Oh, boy.
Once this man was a mighty powerful man, and now his eyes is out. I can just see Samson. Man, help me, please, man. I can't see. Leave me, man.
Mm-hmm.
Wait a minute, man. I can't see.
Mm-hmm.
They put my eyes out. These old Philistines, they put my eyes out.
Mm-hmm.
Man, Mario, don't leave, man.
Mm-hmm.
I can't see.
Mm-hmm.
And he just had his eyes on, but he couldn't see nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm?
Yeah.
He had become what? Helpless.
Mm-hmm.
Hopeless.
Mm-hmm.
Shame.
Mm-hmm.
Disgraced.
Yes.
Once a mighty man, now he ain't nothing.
Helpless. Help.
Please help me, man. Mm. Don't leave. Don't leave me, Mario.
Huh.
Man, I can't see.
Huh.
Where you at, man? Don't leave. Wait a minute. I can't see. You know, he just, man, where you at?
Mm-hmm.
Now, lead me.
Mm-hmm.
Now, he had to have somebody to lead him.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God.
Huh.
That's what happens.
Mm-hmm.
That's what happened to Samson because his eyes got put out.
Mm-hmm. Oh, boy.
Why? Because he kept dibbling and dabbling in sin.
Help.
He was just where the devil wanted him.
Uh-huh.
Now what they gonna do, they gonna make fun of him now.
Help.
Look at him. Was once a power man. Look at him. He ain't about that. Y'all know how people talk about it. He ain't boo-boo. Come on here.
Uh-huh.
Why? Because he can't see. He's blind. And all his hair been shaved off.
Mm.
That was his secret. He gave those secret things to the devil.
Mm.
He made what? Wrong choices.
Yeah.
But even though you make wrong choices, God is yet in it.
Amen.
We all make wrong choices. Amen. I made a whole lot of wrong choices. But God don't throw you away. He's waiting on you to come back to it.
Amen. Amen.
I pity our young people. They just don't know what's coming up on this planet Earth.
Huh.
Young folk, they just don't know. I wish I could get out and just warn them and tell them to get saved, repent, get right with God, but they won't hear most of them. And that's why they're headed for destruction in America.
Tell the truth.
God is tired of American people rejecting him, and they gouge his prosperity and his money and go spend it at casinos and won't give nothing in the church. And think they're going to keep on doing what they're doing. You in for a rude awakening. Because 2022 going to tell you a lot what's going to happen. Uh-huh. It's going to dictate what's going to happen the next 5 years.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah.
Mm. Samson wouldn't listen to his parents. His parents knew what was up.
Mm-hmm.
One thing I know about most folk, when we get a little old, we don't listen to no advice, do we?
Uh-uh.
First thing we say, you can't tell me nothing. He out here doing stuff too. He ain't tell me nothing. I seen him out there doing it. Well, so what you seen him? That don't make it right. Two wrongs don't make right, do it?
That's true. That's a fact. Mm-hmm.
It's not who's right, it's what's right.
Amen.
And the Bible is right.
Amen.
The Word of God is right.
The Word of God is what's right.
Here Samson is, blind, can't see. Mm-hmm. And you know what? He was blind naturally.
Mm-hmm.
But people are blind spiritually.
Uh-huh.
Your eyes are put out.
Yep.
You're blind going to church.
That's
you're blind spiritually. You can't see nothing.
Wow.
God got tired of the churches, the seven churches in Asia Minor. Because they were prospering, doing good. Prosperity destroys people. The Bible is right. The prosperity of fools will destroy them. God had seven churches in Asia Minor, and every one of them had kicked him out, and he had the door knocked. Hey, y'all, let me back in. Wouldn't let him back in. Why? They were doing good. And God wants everybody to do good. God wants you to pay your bills and have a few dollars in your pocket. Because most of y'all couldn't stand $1 million anyway. You're not there. Why do you think all these NBA players and football players, after they finished their career, most of them broke? I mean, you can't have a Rolls Royce and a Bentley all at the same time. Not unless you like LeBron, them. Come on here. One thing I like about LeBron is that I don't hear no scandals on it. Not saying he's perfect. Now, he may be courting and carrying on, but if he was, because they have to deal with what, NBA ball players' ex-wives, and they tell everything. But he don't have no scandals on it. That's amazing, isn't it? There's a whole lot of them. You read in there what they doing, boy. He wasn't like Dennis Rodman. Come on in.
No.
What is Dennis Rodman? He was both of them, wasn't it? Man and woman. He had a wedding. Oh, my God. Yeah, help, yeah. Lord. Samson got his eyes put out. Not only that, the people in the church, their eyes are put out. What happened to the seven churches in Asia Minor? God allowed an earthquake to do what? Destroy them. America is being set up for a tremendous earthquake and a tsunami.
Yeah.
Sodom and Gomorrah is up under the Dead Sea. That's what God thinks about perverts.
Oh boy.
It was so terrible in Sodom and Gomorrah. God came down, sent angels down to deliver Lot and Abraham out of the city. And the men were so perverted, they wanted to have sex with them.
Yeah, they did. That's cold.
LGBT, you on your way to hell if you don't get it right. Stop playing games with God. You don't want to play with God. God will put you up under the ocean. Read the story about Pompeii.
Yeah.
A city in Rome. So-called good people, but they was doing everything. God allowed that volcano to what? Erupt for 24 hours and destroyed them. And a lot of them that died like this. And what they did, they put plaster in them to preserve it. What is that? God let you know what can happen in these United States of America.
Yeah.
Samson left God, but you know what? Let's find out a little bit more about Samson. He came back to God in the 28th chapter. I'm almost back through. See, a lot of us is like Samson. We come to God on our last leg, don't we? I came to God because I was in the Vietnam War, and they told me I had 30 days to live once I got over there. So what did I do? Like any normal person, I come to God. I beg God. God, don't let me die. The wall is 55,700 young men from 18 to 33 that what? Died. And I was supposed to be in that number. But God had mercy on me.
Amen.
See, God let most of us, when we get to the last, don't get on your last leg and come to God. Please. Well, let's see what happened to Samson. He's on his last leg. He got his eyes put out. You think Delilah came to his rescue?
Oh, no.
She was enjoying that money, wasn't she?
Oh,
they paid her well. That old fine girl sitting up there counting that money. And she said, Samson, who's that?
Let's go.
28, and Samson called unto Yahweh. That's in caps in my Bible. Lord mean Yahweh. He didn't get so bad and so perverted that he couldn't call on his God. And Samson called unto the Lord and said, O Lord God, remember me. We want God to remember us, don't we? After all the stuff we have done, we come to the end. God, please help me.
Yes.
Well, Samson really had no choice. What good is a blind man? What girl, what woman gonna marry a blind man? Not unless he got a whole lot of money. Samson was in prison, grinding meal, whatever he was grinding. Any of you ladies want to marry a blind man? Look at they did the head like this here. They kind of reluctant. I guess they say, how much money you got, huh? Don't nobody want to marry a blind old man. Bald headed too? Come on here. You got issues.
Let's go.
So God, Samson is at the end of his life. Did I finish reading that? Oh Lord God, remember me, I pray thee. This is repentance. And strengthen me. See, just because you go through some things in life, that don't mean that God can't come to your aid.
Amen.
People give up on, don't give up on God. Because he hadn't given up on you. All you got to do is call upon him. And ask him to forgive you. Most people, they're too proud to ask God to forgive them. We think we're all right, don't we? They have a saying, why bad things happen to good people. Well, ain't nobody good. We all sinners. You're born in sin. You do stuff because that's your nature. If you call yourself a sinner and you ain't practicing sin, there's something wrong with you. You're going to do just what your nature dictates to you. If your nature say smoke, dope, do this, do that, well, I'm going to do it because that's what my nature is. I don't know if a lot of guys like me, when you get on the weekend, we get low on our wine and whiskey and a joint. We go call up one of our friends, hey, man, what y'all got over there? Y'all do the same thing. Yeah, man, we got something over. Come on over.
Yeah.
I get them over 57 Chevy. Samson is at his last leg. And he's praying a prayer of repentance. I pray thee only this once. One more time. Oh God, that I may be and once avenged of the Philistines for my two eyes. My eyes was put out. My life is shut down. But I pray that you would help me to avenge not only me, but my people.
Yes, amen.
And Samson took hold. He took hold of that pillar. Come on, Mario, come down here again. We get almost about ready to close here. Samson got a hold of that pillar. Now you leave me over here. I'm blind.
Hey, man, the little lad, he said, say, man, lead me over there to them two pillars. Mm-hmm. Come on, man, just lead me over there. Uh-huh. You know, and they was making fun of Samson, laughing.
Uh-huh.
And he got right at them two pillars.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Put his hands on them.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And they just laughing at him. They say, what is that fool doing? you stay around, you're going to see what he's going to do. Stay right there.
Mm-hmm.
He got between them two pillars, boy. They forgot that his hair grew back.
Hmm.
Hmm? They forgot that his hair grew back, and he repented.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm-hmm. See, the devil's something. Mm-hmm. If he can keep you out of repentance, he got you.
Yeah.
But he repented to God and said, God, remember me. I'm sorry.
Yes.
I did so much wrong, but forgive me.
Uh-huh.
Boy, he got between them two pillars, and they laughing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Mark, you got to see. And the Bible said he took one big last heave.
Uh-huh.
Ah!
Huh.
It was over with.
Uh-huh.
They said, look at this fool. And he killed 3,000 of the enemy.
3,000.
God got more glory in his death. See, Samson was at the stage of suicide.
Uh-huh.
Hmm.
Wow.
Anybody ever been close to suicide?
Hmm.
Uh-huh. Some things you go through in life, man. The devil said, oh, won't you just take your life? You ain't got to go through that.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
The devil's a lie. Mm-hmm. God asked Samson if he still wanted to live. He said, no. Mm-hmm. He was fulfilling the will of God in his death.
Uh-huh. Amen.
One thing about I can say about Samson, he didn't blame Delilah them for his downfall and all his women. He didn't blame them. He blamed himself.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. People always want to put the blame game on somebody else. Mm-hmm. Oh, it wasn't for my father. Oh, it wasn't for my mother. It wasn't for my sister, my brother. It wasn't for... Come on, man.
Uh-huh.
You went out and you did it.
Uh-huh.
I tried to tell you, but you won't listen to me.
Uh-huh.
In fact, Samson didn't listen to nobody. He probably threatened his parents, if you don't get that hole down there, I'm going to show you something.
That's sad. Hmm. Let's go.
Hmm. What am I saying? And I'm closing. Samson was fighting what? Depression.
Mm-hmm.
Anxiety.
Mm-hmm.
And low self-esteem.
Mm-hmm.
When people make fun of you, you suffer low self-esteem.
Uh-huh.
Huh?
Mm-hmm.
Anybody ever been made fun of?
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah.
You suffer low self-esteem.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have anxiety.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody ever have anxiety?
Oh, yeah.
Anxiety is tough, man. Sometimes I think you have a heart attack.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
No, you got anxiety.
Hmm.
Now, this one, all you have. Any of y'all ever been depressed?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Okay.
If you ain't depressed, you keep right on living. You're going to find out what depression really is.
Help, Lord, help.
Samson had all of them going. He was depressed, he had anxiety, and he wanted to commit suicide. God intervened.
Amen.
Somebody prayed for Samson.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if didn't nobody pray to him, then the Holy Spirit ministered to him. He said, Samson, you mighty man of God, get up.
Yeah.
Get up, my son, and go ahead and do what you got to do. You're in your last stages. I know you messed up.
Mm.
God knew you was going to mess up when you was born.
Mm.
That's what makes him God.
Uh-huh.
God knows all every hair you got on your head. I still got some hair up there. He knows every hair and is numbered.
Mm-hmm.
Whew, that's some heavy stuff, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
So what did Samson do? He went on and died with the rest of them, because he said, I'd rather die than live in sin and love the world.
Mm-hmm.
When you get that place in God, then you're ready to obey God. I'd rather die than to live in sin and pleasures and enjoy life only for a season, because after this, it's over with.
Uh-huh.
Now we're going to eternity.
Yeah.